What's up, fam? This week we're going to be looking at another video tutorial for Bhujangasana, the snake pose. So this is one of my favorite asanas because it creates a lot of pressure on your abdominal region, automatically strengthens your core, and is a fantastic asana to perform in general. So we're going to look at Bhujangasana and then also go into Sarvasana from the same procedure, which are basically two very similar postures with varying degrees of intensity and upright posture and how upright your posture is. So let's understand how this asana is performed. So first of all, Bhujangasana, the snake pose, is performed in a prone position with your hands near your shoulders this way, and you raise your upper section of the body upwards, making sure that you are not raising beyond your navel region for Bhujangasana. And then when we do Sarvasana, we raise slightly beyond that. So we'll understand that when you actually visualize the tutorial. You'll understand that better when you actually view the tutorial. Apart from that, we also have to make sure that in Bhujangasana, we're not putting too much pressure on our hands. Most of the pressure is situated on our abdominal region. And in Sarvasana, again, there your elbows get locked in, so you do experience pressure on your hands. And you're balancing more so, I would say, in your pelvic region or your legs. So that is how you perform Bhujangasana as well as Sarvasana. Now, let's get into understanding the benefits of these practices. First of all, everything is related to the abdominal core muscles, and they get extremely strengthened, a fantastic massage, the abdominal viscera and all the organs situated within it. Automatically, your thoracic region and your chest opens up more while practicing this asana, so your lung capacity immediately increases just because you're expanding your chest further. Apart from that, you are allowing your neck to be more erect instead of constantly looking downwards. It's allowed to move in an upward direction, and the lower region of your body also experiences a slight amount of pressure, not too much, but it gets used to staying in position and being steady. So there's improved blood flow in the upper body and the circulation is improved, but also in the lower body, because of its steadiness, there's a good base that's formed and it automatically develops muscular strength and tonality as well. So that is the benefit. Apart from that, a few limitations that you do need to keep in mind are that, of course, if you have any kind of, again, digestive issues, if you have hernia or if you have some kind of high blood pressure, you should be careful about performing this asana. Also, if you have spinal issues, lumbar, upper spine, lower spine, coccyx region, any kind of problems, please be careful when performing this asana and ideally consult a doctor before actually taking it on. Apart from that, you should also be mindful that your elbows or your shoulders are not suffering from any injuries. If you just had a shoulder dislocation, might not want to do this practice immediately because it puts direct pressure on your hands and you need to keep them straight, at least in Sarvasana. So these are a few limitations to keep in mind. And also, please remember that you need to be as slow and as careful while performing both of these practices as you possibly can be. Please do not do any kind of jerky movements and maintain your breathing as slow and as deep as it was in Shavasana. So keeping these few pointers in mind, let's get right into the practice and understand how to perform Bhujangasana and Sarvasana.
So today we're going to be looking at Bhujangasana as well as Sarvasana. And in order to practice this, we're going to first sit in Sukhasana or the cross-legged position. We allow our breathing to be as slow, deep and expansive as possible. And we make sure that we're entirely in the present moment, having gained sufficient control over our thoughts. And then we move into the Shavasana position or the dead person's pose, where we make sure there is 1.5 feet distance between both our legs. Our hands are slightly away from the body, palms facing upwards, and our breathing is slow and deep. Now gently we're going to turn over onto our abdominal region or the prone position in order to do Bhujangasana as well as Sarvasana. Once you've turned over, you make sure your heels and toes are together at the back, hands are by the side of the body, and you're just preparing yourself to actually begin the practice of the asanas. Now, once you feel like you've relaxed sufficiently, you move your hands into your chest or closer to your chest, and you make sure your middle finger is in line with your shoulder. Once you've done that, you start to raise your upper body off the mat, making sure the lower body is still on the mat. And you're only rising up till your navel region because this is Bhujangasana. All of the pressure is on your abdominal region, barely any pressure on the palms. Elbows are inwards, as close to the body as possible. And then we go downwards with the exhalation, placing the forehead on the mat once again and waiting for a few seconds before we practice Sarpasana, or the complete cobra position. In Sarpasana, we are going to be raising our upper body more than Bhujangasana. So we just mentally prepare for that. And then once we've made sure that our heels and toes are touching each other, hands are still by the side of the body, elbows are inside, then very slowly and gently, we raise our upper body off the mat as high as possible for us, this time locking in the elbows and straightening them out. So your hands are at 90 degree angle to the mat. The lower body is still placed on the mat and is not raising off. Please make sure that your feet are together at this point, because there's a tendency for the heels and toes to separate, but make sure they're together. And then very slowly and gently, you come back down onto the mat, placing the forehead on the mat, and then very slowly and gently releasing the hands, bringing them by the side of the body, and then slowly changing your position, turning over onto the right hand side, using the left hand to propel yourself upwards, coming back into the sitting position and being seated on the mat. So you come back into Sukhasana, the cross-legged position, hands in Gyan Mudra, eyes are still closed, and you're just reflecting on the asana that you performed and then making sure you're ready to complete the practice.
So that was the practice of Bhujangasana as well as Sarpasana, and I hope that you've understood how to perform these asanas perfectly. Go ahead and practice them on your own here onwards, and please be careful while practicing the asana. Remember to take it as slowly as you possibly can and not to have any jerky movements while actually doing the asana. Remember that your health and safety and the positioning of your body comes first, so do not do anything that's causing you pain or is taking you away from your yogic practice. Apart from that, I hope that this helps you. We're going to be looking at sitting asanas in the next video tutorial, so that you can then build up a good sequence of basic asanas to practice on your own for about 30 to 40 minutes. So keeping that in mind, I will see you next week with another video tutorial. Until then, keep blasting.